Okay, everyone, I've been promising new content, and this is going to be the section where we start. It won't be the only new content we add, but it will be some of the important stuff. Let's go back to here real quick. This is our launcher, and this is the scene we usually see when we open our launcher. Make sure you're on Unreal Engine 4.14, because that has all these new features that we're going to be talking about. You can update that by going to your library, say adding versions, or just check for updates here. Once we launch, it'll bring up our normal screen, and you'll probably see this. We're a collection of all your projects. I want to go to New Project, and here is the new feature that we're going to talk about. This is the virtual reality template, which makes it super easy for us to use UE4 with a headset, an HMD as they call them, head-mounted display, and you can use this specifically with Occulus Rift and HTC Vive, which are both awesome products. I use HTC Vive, I love it. It's really, really cool if you haven't done it. Unfortunately, I don't have one hooked up to this computer, but that's okay, I can still explain to you how to do everything that you need to do. So let's create a new project by clicking on this template, go to desktop console. Actually, no, sorry, mobile. Okay, and this is kind of scaling everything down so that we don't have a bunch of junk in there that we don't need because we want to optimize it. When we're running in virtual reality, everything needs to run clean and smooth, and we do it by keeping any unnecessary stuff out of there. So set it to scalable 3D, no starter content. I'm gonna browse for a new place. Okay, name it whatever you want, obviously. No spaces though. Okay, create project. Okay, when it comes up, you'll see that this is a VR template. This one over here on the left is HMD plus gamepad optional. That is the template for the Oculus Rift. This HMD plus motion controller. This has the hands, as you'll see. And these are used with the HTC Vive. Okay, so these have motion controllers that you hold, and that controls those hands. It's really cool. I prefer this method. And what you do is you use the motion controllers to warp from one place to another, or you can walk within this small box that is defined by the area that you're physically standing in the real world. Okay, so you set that up. You can walk within that box, and then you can warp to another area. And you can use your hands to grab things and interact with things. So that's awesome. With this one, you use a gamepad while you're wearing a headset, or you can use your keyboard to control yourself too. I'm going to talk about the HTC Vive. That's the one I'm used to using. So what we can do is just open level, search for the right one, virtual reality BP, maps, and we'll go to the motion controller map. To get to the other one, you would go there. Okay, here we are in the motion control map. You'll see that everything's basically set up for us here. These blocks are able to be picked up, which is awesome. If you walk over to these or warp over to them, you can use the trigger to pick these up and they'll all interact with each other using physics, which is great. This is our VR pawn, which you'll notice is at the ground, and that's because when you set up your VR headset, you will be telling the VR headset how tall you are, basically, when you calibrate it. So it will take that height into account. So if you set this at the ground, then the camera will actually move when you start to your actual eye height. So that's exactly right there. Okay, so this is cool. If you have a headset, you can just get right into this and start trying it out. Now let me talk about some of the special features in here. If you're not used to all this, what you will be seeing. So if you hit P while you're in here, you'll see this green mesh appear over the top of your floor. That is your navigation mesh. Okay, so we'll go out here and look at what all is going on here. This here, I believe, that's the post-process volume. Let's see. This one is the light mass importance volume. We know what those are already. It's this one here. This is a nav modifier volume 12. Okay, so that is a nav modifier. The way that this is created is by using geometry box, and you just use a box brush. Okay, I'll bring this in as an example. This is a box brush, and that's all this one is too. Box brushes can be converted to anything, basically. And so that one's created into a navigation mesh, which tells your motion controllers on your that are connected to your headset, your virtual reality, where you are able to navigate. So you see around these boxes and stuff, you can't navigate right into them. You can only navigate where it's green. So when you're warping, it won't let you drop right here, but it will let you drop right here. So back to this box that I brought in, you can set these boxes to do different things. So you can convert it to an actor, which is a Navmesh bounds volume, a Nav modifier volume. So you could do that, where now it's no longer a mesh in your scene, it is just this box that makes it so you cannot walk through this particular part of the scene. So that's great. Now this one out here is actually telling it where you can walk. So this one's been converted to a nav mesh bounds volume. This one is created, is as you saw, I converted into a nav mesh modifier, which actually cuts out from that thing. So there's some of these in here for like these areas over here. You'll see that there's nav mesh modifier volumes underneath of it, and making it so you can't navigate to those places. So the nav mesh is an important part of VR that you'll need to pay attention to. And these box brushes are a great way to modify that. You can make it so that this blocks a large area by adjusting this, and you'll see that now you cannot go over into that area. So if you are creating a building, you'll want to make it so that the nav mesh is inside the building but not out, so you can't go outside and see all your crappy modeling out there. You don't want any of that. Okay, so that's cool. If you want to make other objects in your scene able to be picked up, you can, well, there's a couple different things you can do. One of the easiest ways I found is to search for this in the content browser, this little pickup cube, and you can just copy this or duplicate it to a new one. Call it pickup. Let's turn off caps lock. Pickup object. Okay, and double click on it. And you'll see it has all this scripting built in already. The important part about this is that in the class settings of this object, there's this pickup actor interface enabled, and you can do that on any object by going here and saying add pickup. Well, it's already there, so it's not going to show me, but pickup actor interface is the one you want to add, and that tells UE4 that this is a object that can be picked up, and so it will enable certain events, and namely these event pickup and event drop. Okay, so once that's available, then you can make scripting that applies to picking up objects. And then what you can do is just select all of that, hit Control C, and then go to another object that you've created, like a sphere, right? And you can turn that into a blueprint. We haven't talked about blueprints yet. We will a little bit later in the course. But let's just create a blueprint with this sphere here. We can go into the event graph, and like I said, we can go to class settings. We can add the pickup interface, at which point now we can, in the events graph here, we can now paste Control V. Okay, so there's that way to do this, and that's not everything you have to do. You have to make sure a couple other settings are right too. The other way to do it is that duplicate I made. So finding content browser. Here's our duplicate here, pickup object. You can now edit this one, and this is different than the one that's in the scene already. You can see it's just this little box here. But within this blueprint, you can change which static mesh it's talking about, or it's referencing, I should say. So let's say we have a different mesh in here. What do we got? Some fat cylinder. That's just a default thing in there. Okay, so now that is the same exact blueprint, but it's referencing this fat cylinder instead of the box. You can compile and save that. Yeah, this is probably the easiest way to do it. Okay, now you have this little cylinder that you can pick up instead. Okay, that's an object that can be picked up already. Now, if you have objects already in your scene, you can do what I was showing before and copy and paste. You do have to make sure, let's go into the sphere and just make sure there's some other things that we need to do. If we go into Edit Blueprint, Viewport. Okay, if you turn Simulate Physics on, that will adjust some of these other things down here, but we don't actually want it on. Okay, so because then if you start the scene, it will just automatically start falling. And that's not exactly what we want. We want it to have physics enabled when we pick it up, but not before we do. Okay, so let's make sure it does all these things. Block all dynamic. It's fine. Make sure it's movable. Okay, otherwise you can't pick it up. And I think that should have you set. There might be a few other things that you need to adjust. You'll have to match them to these other objects. Let's look in here and see what we've got going on, just to make sure it's all working properly. And you'll want to match this. So this is actually a physics actor. These are both checked. Physics is not turned on though. You also need to make sure that the object has a collision on it. So this thing needs the actual mesh of this, the sphere mesh. Let's search for that sphere mesh. Remember, this is just a reference. We need to open this sphere. That's a good way to do it right there, by just clicking on it right here. Make sure this has a collision on it. So add simplified sphere collision. Okay, so that needs a collision on it. It needs to be able to have that interface enabled. You need to copy and paste the script, and then you need to make sure that it matches the same kind of... So this is actually a physics actor. It's fine. That works. We can do that too. And that should work for you. So there's a couple different ways to do it. You can do it with any object you want. You can also just copy one of these and replace it with any object you want, like that. Any static mesh in your scene can be replaced in there. So you can just copy the blueprints and keep doing that. That's probably the easiest way that I found. And those you'll be able to pick up with your virtual reality hand motions. Okay, one interesting thing that I've found is that if you're copying all this stuff into your new scene, it's really hard to get it to work because all the different scripts and things that are tied into this virtual reality. It's actually easier if you bring your meshes, your building, into here. So the building that we've been using with the class, you could import all the geometry into here. And you'd probably have better luck than trying to create a nav mesh and bring in all these scripts in, you know, in the other direction. One thing that is essential if you are trying to set it up in another scene is this box brush here, which is just a box brush, geometry, box brush, right? It's just a big box, and it is somehow essential to creating this nav mesh properly. So you have to have this box here. You have to have a nav modifier volume, that one, that intersects with it, and then that will create, with the P button again, will show you your nav mesh, and then you can put your geometry right on top of this. I would suggest putting your floor right above this box brush down here, and then just adding your geometry like I've showed throughout the course, but not in the first person shooter, but in this one, and you can delete all the stuff you don't need, and then you'll just be able to walk around and navigate through your scene using a VR headset, which is pretty dang cool. So hopefully that's helpful for you. There's a couple other housekeeping items. You will want to make sure that if you go to Edit, Plugins, and go to VR, make sure, so if I'm using the HTC Vive, which uses Steam VR, so make sure that's enabled. Make sure whatever headset you're using is enabled. Occulus Rift is right there. Okay, and then one other thing, when you package your project for, at least I know for HTC Vive, package project, you just do it for Windows 64-bit like normal, but you do need to go to the level blueprint, similar to that exit command that we gave. So we need to set up a button, like right-click and hit F1. Oh, that's not going to work for me. 1. Okay, we'll say, there's F1 right there. F1. Okay, we'll say when that's pressed in the level blueprint, so anytime the level's running, we want to give it a console command, execute console command, and we'll want to say stereo on. Okay, so that's basically running a console command, telling the computer something to do, and the command we're giving it, we're plugging into it, is stereo on, okay? And what that does is when you execute this file after it's been packaged and you're running on your desktop, you want to be able to turn stereo on, which sends it to your headset. So you need a button to do that, and that will be F1. And of course, you'll want to be able to escape too, so you can do escape. Nope. I gotta type it in apparently. Escape. Okay. Escape. When that's pressed, we can run another console command, which I've showed you before, and I believe that's exit. Okay. So that exits out of the software. Otherwise, you'll just be stuck in it and you'll have no way out. Okay, and we'll talk about blueprints and other instances as well, and in more depth, which will be great because it adds interactivity to what we're trying to do. But this is to just run your virtual reality stuff. You'll need a couple buttons that will help you out. So if you are executing a package project and it's not going to your headset and it's just showing on your screen, you'll need a button to say F1, turn on stereo, and that'll just boop, zap it right to your headset, and then you'll be good to go. So those are some of the things I found working with VR, which is awesome, by the way. I love working with VR. So yeah, hopefully that's helpful for you in getting up and running with the template. And like I said, I would start with the template, delete what you don't need, and then merge your project into here because everything's running properly. It's really hard to get everything running properly if you're trying to go the other direction because there's so many different little scripts in places you won't even realize exist that are running all this stuff. So this is the easiest way to do it. Okay, hopefully that's helpful.